The Philippine Stock Exchange bucked the regional downswing on Monday. The main index was up 1.2% to close at 65.98. Value turnover was seeing a recovery as well. The figure returns to the 5 billion level after it was down below 4 billion for most of the previous week. And to help us again make sense of today's market movements, we're joined by Nisha Alicer, Chief Equity Strategist at DA Market Securities. Nisha, again, glad to have you on the program.
Hi, Stanley, and thank you for having me. Happy to be here.
Okay, now the banks were the clearly the biggest gainers today following last week's income reports. I presume a lot of good and positive releases from BPI and BDO. We're also seeing BPI and BDO, as well as even Metro Bank, actively trading today. It appears like thin trading is also concentrated on this specific sector. We're seeing the financial counters significantly up as well. What's your analysis?
Sure. The banks are still benefiting really from the positive sentiment and the earnings show for it that they're benefiting from the higher interest rates. And so if you take a look at the top three big banks, they've been trading at the highs of the stock. Yeah.
All right. We also saw the market touching almost 6,600. Volume was improving today compared to last week's critical lack of participation. Would you say this is already the return of interest in equities market, or do you still think this is a very short-term, all-for-the-day bounce above 5 billion?
I would have to say that we're still waiting for more impetus for the market to really move up. So pulling back, we'll have to admit that we're still in this consolidation phase, especially because net foreign selling hasn't actually abated from last year's big volume.
Okay, we're still trading closer to support, at least for the past few days last week, than near-term resistance. Today was an exception. We hit almost 6,600. We're also ending the month soon. So what's there to look forward to in May, and what news or even data do you think would sustain this kind of rally?
Sure. Well, actually, we are a little bit hesitant to say that the rally can continue. Seasonally, we're approaching May, and that usually, I think based on what the market has done, you know, in the past 12 months, we could be looking at a sell in May and go away. But this also means that you should be ready to buy. From 6.6 resistance, if that doesn't get broken, and considering the headwinds of a weaker peso, inflation concerns still ongoing, we could be looking at supports tested again at 6.2 or 6.3, but that would definitely be an interesting time to come and take a look at the market again.
Yeah, speaking of data, Nisha, we just received a report about recalibration of inflation figures for the rest of the year. How do you think might the market price in recalibration, higher expected inflation by government itself?
Sure. Well, I think businesses will now have to prepare. So that probably implies that input will still be higher, and therefore businesses will have to be able to contend with being able to pass it on to consumers, or managing that their costs will be kind of renegotiated, recontracted with suppliers or something like that. And so that means that there might be, you know, opportunities on the buying side for companies that will be impacted by higher inflation input costs. But at the same time, you've got companies that could be exporting, they would probably remain more competitive in terms of being able to take advantage of a weaker peso. I think it's really a balancing in portfolio. Have to take a look at where the opportunities are. But overall, if you're investing in the market today, it's an opportunity to come in for a medium and long-term position, especially with interesting values that we're seeing in certain sectors.
All right. Now, before government released new expectations as to targeted or projected inflation for 2023, we are already seeing inflation easing. In fact, into the first or second week of May, the new inflation figures would have been out, and we were already anticipating, of course, more positive developments on the policy side, with Banco Central even hinting a pause in rates. Now, are the new projections affecting perhaps the central bank decision to pause rates and to continue? Because you have that inflation projection jump that's expected or anticipated for the year. What do you think?
This will definitely influence policy moving forward, and at the same time, I mean, the banking crisis that that brought about a pause in rates in the U.S. and in the Philippines, there seems to be a little bit of a differential. But looking at what we have to contend with, that inflation can still continue to be riskier moving forward. Also, considering that there's climate change impact is becoming more and more apparent, and so the increase in prices in rice and sugar that's brought about by drought, not just the war, seasonal factors, and so it could be a more of an ongoing concern, really, a more normalized concern.
All right, lastly, and going back to the equities market, let's talk about the charts now and technicals. What are the charts telling us about technicals, from the technical perspective? Is the consolidation following the recent C wave still on a downward bias? What are you seeing?
It's more of on a pause. So we could look at it that way. And then it's really consolidating. So when you're consolidating, the market is still trying to figure out which direction it wants to go. Factoring in the fundamental aspects of it, we think that it would be better to be more prudent, to err on the weaker possibility of the market for the longer term picture, which is that we do think that we are in the upside swing of a larger wave, which means that we've experienced already the big wave 5 down, and then we are actually within possibly the start of a third wave.
All right. On that note, Nisha Ali Ser, DA Securities, thank you so much for your market guidance. Have a good day.
You're welcome, Stanley. Thank you.